Hey, I'm George Strombolopoulos. That's me. For the last 25 years, I've been lucky enough to interview the best bands in the world. Only now, it's time to take that party and bring it home. To my home in downtown Toronto. So, the biggest bands, your future heroes. Fire up the amps, roll up the carpets, and don't tell the neighbors. We are about to throw a massive party, and you're invited. Beat can be a powerful force. And when that force comes from a place of truth, well, it can unify a people. And that is what the three DJs and producers of A Tribe Called Red have figured out. Imagine this, a dance record that challenges the history of cultural genocide. It works as much at a party as it does at a protest. As it says in the patches sewn on their jackets, 500 years and still drumming. Are you ready for it? This house party's about to go off. It's A Tribe Called Red.
We are the tribe that they cannot see. We live on an industrial reservation. We are the Halusa Nation. We have been called the Indians. We have been called Native American. We have been called hostile. We have been called pagan. We have been called militant. We have been called many names. We are the Halusa Nation. We are the human beings. The callers of names cannot see us, but we can see them. We are the Halusa.
This is the craziest house party I've been to in a minute. Thank you so much, George, for having us. We really appreciate it.
Alright, that direct descent into the mouth, man, gibberish. Means I got a little edge in it. Our battle plan will be that of an Apache resistance. Warriors. You join my command, you take on them. Devin, you owe me, personally. Each and every man under my command owes me 100 scouts. I want my scouts.
Are you in a position that you ever thought you would be in?
No.
No?
Huh.
Tell me about that journey.
Well, every day's a surprise.
Yeah. When we started this, it kind of just was, we wanted to throw a party. Like, legit, like, we just wanted to be, like, throw a party for indigenous people.
Right.
And that was all we wanted to do.
What do you mean, like, one party, like, make a record?
It was one party. We just wanted to throw one party. And then, like, that was it. That was where this, like, started. And that's how high our expectation was for this project.
When did you figure out that this was more than just a party?
It was right away. We got, like, a really quick response from the people that were there saying, we need this. And it turned out that there was, it was people coming in from isolated communities up north who were coming to Ottawa and not, you know, coming from a community of a few hundred to, like, a million. There's a bit of a culture shock. And there was so they said that, you know, coming to a space and seeing other indigenous people really, really help them with this process, and that we couldn't stop this.
When did you get a sense that this party wasn't just for indigenous people?
When not just indigenous people showed up.
Yeah, was that a surprise to you?
Definitely. Yeah? Definitely. Well, at the same time, like, we were known DJs in town, and, like, it was never based on being indigenous. Like, we were just, like, DJs.
Yeah.
And it wasn't until we sat down, I was like, hey, maybe we should try something like this. It turned into this thing that, like, you can't stop this. This is really important. And then it turned into a monthly, and then it turned into just wanting to give back to this indigenous community who said that they needed it. And that's when we just started, like, playing powwow music and just seeing if that worked.
The big change was when we started remixing our own music.
Yeah.
That was, like, when we started putting out our own music, that was kind of the big aha moment.
As opposed to, like, just DJing a set.
Yeah, because in the beginning, that's all we were doing. We were just DJing
like
we did in any other club night.
Yeah. I suppose in the first few, when you were playing shows and you were hearing from the outside world, were you getting a sense that it wasn't just Canadian or people, indigenous people in this part of the world that were relating to it?
Yeah, and not just relating to it, but had the same idea.
Yeah,
like it exploded across the world within the same, like, 3-4 year period. Mm. We started seeing people from South America, from Central America, from Australia, from everywhere,
South Africa,
had this idea to be like, it's time to start using our culture in a different way and showing people our culture in a different way.
Shake George's house a bit. We'll be right back.
dirty dog out if we put the whole iron pan them. We can't live in a peace card, the whole of them. In five of them and never cause problems.
See that girl with the big thing, tight, she be gimme the, bend to the floor, girl, gimme the, lean over, girl, and gimme the, spin down to the ground, ties big activity, spin round me, girl, and gimme the, top wine, girl, and gimme the, body look fine, girl, gimme the, coming out, waste the time, girl, gimme the,
it's perfect timing in a lot of ways, because all of a sudden this conversation about reconciliation, I know that this is a conversation that Indigenous peoples have heard a lot over the years, and there's a lot of hope and there's a lot of suspicion. I'm sure there's a lot of fatigue as well from the outside world saying, now we're going to take it seriously. How do you guys feel about where the conversation is today?
It's moving. Yeah. It's really exciting. It's definitely moving in a progressive way. There's definitely a lot of work to be done and a lot of more things that needs to be confronted and needs to be discussed in this place that we like to call Canada right now as what it is.
What's your level of hope versus reality versus I've seen this record, I heard this record before?
Go ahead. Well, I was just gonna say that's the thing with me. It's like it's something that's always been there. Like, I've heard of all before, kind of thing. And but I think that with the traction that we've been getting, and you know, like I think Canada in itself really wants to change as well. Yeah. Like, you know, there's a sense of like that people want to grow up now, and people want to accept things and respect things. You know, it's crazy getting like respect back in that kind of work and in that way. But yeah, it's definitely like along that lines. But I'm a show and prove kind of guy, so like I'd love to just see some action on it. And then as soon as that happens, you know, then I'll be on board, you know. But like, yeah, until then, that, and it's kind of, I'm still kind of weary, because I think because we've been hurt before, tons of times. So it's like, you know, and that as soon as that gets over, we get over that hump, then I think we'll see some real change happening.
People are ready to change where the conversation's even been at,
right?
Because the conversation's been at in a place that is stagnant. It's, you know, it's, we're stuck in this place where we're all angry at each other, and you know, if we can start having the conversations from a place where of understanding and stop smashing our heads together, being so mad at each other all the time,
right,
then we can actually start making some steps forward. Hey!
Playlists and you have set lists that you put together when you're DJing, and you're pulling songs out for certain reasons.
Just any that are oppressive, I find. I'm trying to not oppress as much as I can. I'm trying to be the ally that I want and need to combat racism. And yeah, so any misogyny, any racism, anything like that, like I
homophobia, transphobia,
anything like that. I just try not to play.
You're pulling all that out.
Yeah, what absolutely.
What are you playing?
Do it. Lots of house music.
Yeah. Right.
You know what I mean? Yeah. Like it's true though, and like combing through, man, it's really tough. It's definitely tough, and like realizing that like through misogyny as men, using terms like bitch and stuff like and whore and any derogatory term against women being the people in power is the same as non-indigenous people calling me a redskin.
Right.
It's the exact same thing. They're, misogyny and racism are the same tools used to oppress different demographics of our society. It's the same thing.
All my indigenous sisters out there, make some noise right now. All the men out there, make some noise for those indigenous sisters right now. This song's for you, the indigenous sisters.
Ladies and gentlemen.
All right, all right. Thank you all so much. I just want to take 1 second to say how important this last song we're going to play off our new record is. The first time we heard it was with our brother Leonard Sumner here. And, you know, he performed the first verse you can hear off this song for us in Winnipeg, you know, just for the guys here. And we said, we need that song on our album. You know, so that's how it ended up here. And, you know, getting the collaboration so with Shad on it as well. So you guys really, really brought it on the song. So I'm happy you guys are here behind me right now as I'm going to hit play.
Leonard and Shad!
We had planned to have Shad jump up here, but Leonard surprised us by showing up tonight. So, for the first time ever.
How about a hand for a Tribe Called Red?
Yes, yes. You are rocking with the best, a Tribe Called Red. Give it up one time. My man Leonard Sumner's in the house. Give it up one time. Yeah.
Well, I could never imagine the pain in the mother's heart when life takes a turn for the worse and creator's art becomes another canvas that will never be completed. I'm a few degrees away and a thousand times defeated. My energy's depleted, but I wanna stand and fight, swinging with the speed instead of travel back into the light. I feel the tears and depression, fears and aggression woven in society from years of oppression. The violence is normalized, the silence is all fine. Truth is denied and the fact is there's more dying. You won't have to tell me how you feel, 'cause I can see it in your eyes. Well, it's hard to listen, but listen, 'cause it's much harder listening and living with the hardships till the heart's conditioned to condition the air when the air conditions keep it cool with the more tears, sometimes a clearer the vision. Now what I see, been a long time carving and driving, running, rocking, reaching new so them youngins can finally summit, climbing high above it, climb from it up to the skies, overstanding the corruption and deconstructing the lies. I see this country decline, try to keep discussions combined, how the underside over extract and try to undermine. But I still believe in the truth. Come from an MNC in a booth or a PhD in a suit. Yo, where we at and protest? Tell them I'm feeling in peace, but we protest. Bro, testify to the will of the people. Tell them I think my snow. Turn it up loud when we bust blows. Not in hush tones, speaking up. Let the trust grow. So you don't gotta tell me how you feel. 'Cause I can see it in your eyes. You don't gotta tell me that the pain is real. 'Cause I can hear it in your cries. Rockin' with the best, the Tribe Called Red in Georgia's house. Yeah! Yeah! Ask what's up. Ask what's up. Well, it's the type of heartbreak that takes more than tears of time to stitch up any wounds and heal the scars and leave behind a separation from the fear, segregation on the land. It was all part of the plan and the blood is on their hands. Divide and conquer, colonize and slaughter, stabbing at the heart to the backs of our grandfathers. Now we see our daughters that is disappearing quickly, saying through the cracks while ignoring all the history. Government's been scooping babies way before the 60s. When you legalize abduction, you legalize the misery. So now you see the mystery, it's really not too complicated. Justice is unequally distributed by observation. Money can be made while the kids are getting isolated, splitting up a family, and now becoming occupation. And it's been part of the occupation since residential schools and forced starvation. It's a nation with racism. Yeah, since the start of it, hard to let go, 'cause it's carved in the heart of it. Relates to the land and our rise where we're start of it. Roots where I stand, I could never depart from it.
Thank you so much for a Tribe Called Raitt.
Yo, thank you everyone for coming out. It was great. This is probably one of the awesomest shows we've ever done. A house party in Toronto. Like,
yeah, too much fun. Too much fun. Thank you so much. Thank you everybody for coming down. This is.
Thank you guys so much. Thank you everybody for coming to the show tonight. What a party it was. This is unbelievable.